to really be remote. As a band, it kind of almost a wasted thing. Because it's just not really played, so
I'm hoping
there we go. So we are starting with a jump heavy map with Amai Hachimitsu in the Polish team now.
We saw some crazy plays on this.
Yeah, I remember the almost double full combo from the South Korea side. And also a really strong performance here. Yeah. Also, Poland performing extremely well on this bitmap.
Rich is saying my kryptonite, and I wonder if he's gonna still stay in.
I think he should.
I think Vitzer could do well on this. I mean, he's got some really good aim map scores, so I think he'd be able to manage this one. But yeah, like you mentioned, Poland did so well on this when they played it in the previous matches. So well, I'm not surprised to see it fix it. Couple full pretty annihilated this map when they played against Korea. That said, when I think of the US team, I look at people like Natalia and Zilva and Xerius, I think of the sick consistency. So I'm thinking no mod is somewhere where the US team's really going to shine. Maybe on the mod picks, you might falter a bit, but yeah, when it comes to these kind of standard no mod maps, they should be doing really well on it. Or at least I think they would.
I think US's very big weak point versus Poland especially is going to be the double time.
Yeah. I mean, the Polish team has so many double time specialists, really. They can just pick and choose. Don't really want to play that, and the US are a little bit more limited. Only a bit, though. I mean, they're still competitive, but they'll be on the back foot, yeah, like I say.
This is going to be the first match, and it is kind of, well, it's kind of high to note that even if Toy could play, which it looks like he might actually.
He's here.
Oh yes. My god, he's here.
Yes.
Oh,
is
wow.
He actually going to be on his laptop, though?
What a time to be alive.
Wow, if Toy carried this one, it would be incredibly insane.
But yeah, so I'm not familiar with why Toy couldn't make it, so as I said, I assume he's on a laptop or something, but hey, it's good to see him in.
Yeah, most definitely. If I'm correct, I might have my information a little bit wrong. Twitch chat, feel free to correct me if you guys know. But I do believe Toy is at his dorm this weekend, so I'm sure if he is playing, it has to be on a laptop of some sort.
He said he wasn't supposed to play today. There was just so much hype. All for nothing.
Ah, I was correct. Laptop lag is too strong.
But he's still gonna go?
Yeah, he says he's gonna go.
Oh, wow.
Oh, boy.
This is highly risky on the United States side, if I do say so myself, but maybe Toy will be able to impress.
It's Poland's pick, so it's not really that risky.
Please, Toy, I believe.
But the first point is very important, Juan. Like, that's the whole moral setter for the entire match. Morale, not
morale.
Yeah, I totally meant morale.
The moral of the story is... Oh, please, Toy, I believe in you.
Oh, Natalia having the first break here of the match. That's not great for the United States team, but this is a really early miss, so it might not really matter at all at the end. We just have to wait and see. Silver now falling as well. Not a great start for the North America team.
Amaya is going to be seeing a miss though, so that could give the US a slight chance at this. This is in the earlier part of the map as well, and Natalia building up a decent combo.
Yeah, you see the gaps begin to close now. The accuracy advantage from Toy and Xerius.
I think this is still kind of even combo-wise, because Amaya is behind both Natalia and Silver in combo. He's ahead of neither, so... I mean, as you can see, the scores are like 10k apart, so...
Yeah, accuracies are really close between each other, and everyone is holding 98 at least, which is really impressive.
Oh, Toy and Wolf gonna be seeing a break on those triangles.
That's same really point.
Combo left to America.
Scores.
It is so
very even, though. The ending is where we'll see the breaks.
Xerius and Rappi is having a 99.18 accuracy.
Look at the difference. 8,000 points. That's almost nothing. We have to wait and see who's the first breaking here. Might be Wichu, Raphis, Axaris, or maybe Natalia, who's holding also a really strong
Silver.
Combo.
Oh, it's Silver, of all people. Oh,
and
we were
Toy
saying
shortly
great.
After again.
Poland immediately
gonna get
quite the
lead
to hard part.
Unless Poland breaks soon, Natalia breaking, this is not going to be good. Amaya breaking, but they have two strong full combos going on Poland's end. But Raphis is going to break, and this is one full combo to one.
Yeah, it's all up
is
in the hands of Wichigu right now. Let's see if he
can
Wolf
is
going to
build your weapon! Xari is the only full combo left! Wolf is the only high combo on Poland's end, and this is looking like it could go to United States' way. Zilver, Xarius, and Natalia both 200 plus combo. Xarius with the FC still. There's still a good chunk of the map left, so this is a very big possibility to happen.
It's going to be
US
close, though.
They're all breaking again. Wolf breaks! That is going to bring a lead over to United States! United States now has the lead over Poland, and Xerius is still holding a full combo strong. Poland is not able to hold it together. Wolf is the only 200 combo. Xerius breaking with Natalia and the combo.
He just has to survive.
Oh, Natalia and Silver breaking. This is really close. What is going to happen? Oh my god.
There isn't enough time.
And the United States.
Not enough time.
United States is going to win by 60,000 points. Wow.
Great map to start us off. It was back and forth all the way.
I'm really worried about Toy, though. He was getting a lot of misses.
Such a strong performance by Xerius, though.
First blood to the United States.
850,000 points coming from Xerius. The highest score by 200,000 points, keep in mind.
A really close match, and Xerius managing to pull that out with an impressive combo missing right in the end in the spaces streams. But it wasn't enough for Poland to take back that lead, and the United States is leading now 1-0, and they had the pick, so they're in a really, really good spot.
Oh yeah, they definitely are. If they can make this point theirs and take it 2-0 this early against Poland, that could really get them into a good mindset for the rest of the match. It's just so important getting those early points, but of course, anything can happen, as we've seen so many times.
Absolutely. If US get to the next point, then they're going to be fairly good, but if Poland take the next one, back to square one, really. The first point definitely helps you getting you in position, but really, 1 point ain't nothing.
Exactly. Worth noting that Zilver actually has a stable rate of 77. Wait, no way.
No way.
Oh, wow. Is this happening?
It's happening.
They are using Toy.
Is Toy the boy gonna stay in for the hidden pick? Oh, and Toy
we're soulless. We're soulless though.
Rafi's subbing out for Spajder.
Spider, really?
Yeah.
Spajder.
Hey, with Toy there and it's hidden, you have to have him in there.
You really do.
Yeah, you do.
There's no really one else that you would want
over
with the Toy.
With the lag top though.
Exactly. Yeah.
Play hidden with well the lag, with the lag top.
Yeah, that's the worrying issue.
When Z-Truck gets back, he's probably gonna have a baby.
If he gets back in time.
Yeah.
I hope for his sake he does. I don't think he'd ever forgive himself for missing this.
So I'm just gonna put this out there. I don't know if the storyboard is showing on Osu Live, but if it is, epilepsy warning at
it
the
won't. It
breakdown
won't.
Part of the map.
It won't.
Epilepsy warning.
But yes, Chippy, you are very much right.
I almost had a heart attack when I saw it for the first time playing this game.
I think this one and Strange Program were really the two that killed my eyes back when I used to play with Storyboard.
Yeah. Good old Strange Program. So we do see Solus come in as well, though, as we
Yeah. Oh, but they took out
enough. Ooh, Solus is going to be playing instead of 0120. Ritzy coming in instead of Zilver. Poland's keeping most of their lineup, though, except for Rafius. I think we'll be expecting some Wobbuff Wolf FC here, most likely.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. If anybody.
Oh my God! I'm so glad I came back for this.
Hey.
Yeah, we were just talking about that, Dietra. I don't think you'd forgive yourself for missing this one.
Oh, I would have been so mad.
If Toy can play well
on
his
break.
If Toy can play well on his lag top, I can kind of predict like a Toy versus Wolf situation right here.
I won't be surprised if we see CO-less as well holding the combo.
Spider seeing him break.
Yeah, those eight legs flopping around a little bit. Spider getting three or two early breaks, dropping some accuracy as well. Everybody else holding strong though. Once the song gets intense though, we will see breaks. It's not even a question.
Yeah, really, it's gonna be down to the CO-less Toy and Wobbuff Wolf. They've got a guys to really carry the team. Everyone else is going to struggle on this one, I think.
I never saw the storyboard of this one, but I can imagine how it would be.
Oh yeah, on the
flashes basically.
Part, there's like black and white flashes, literally.
Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah, if the storyboard was enabled or any of the players were playing with the storyboard enabled, that would be very, very.
Amaya seeing a break.
US holding four full combos, but Amaya, Hachimitsu, and Spider just cannot seem to hold her, and the Spider is
really
Ritzy
gonna
be
man, break.
The curse coming into effect, but still one break to two right now. The US still very much has the advantage. That can change in a moment, and it does, because I think we saw a break from Solus.
We do, yeah. And there's two full combos over on Poland's side with high accuracy right now, so that's going to give a good point increase to Poland. However, Spider is going to be breaking, so...
Yeah, Spider is so much behind right now. They don't really have the chance to come back here if...
Wilch is going to be seeing a miss.
Wilch actually breaks.
Oh.
And it's only up to Toy and Axarius to just hold that combo up, and they will get the, this victory, this point. Bitchku on
they can do it.
Will's not able to hold it together. Axarius and Toy are playing so strongly right now. Toy's accuracy isn't that great, but he's still holding a really high combo, as is Axarius with the better accuracy.
But Toy! Toy's our boy!
Toy's playing. Oh!
You say that and he missed.
But however, that's gonna be a US win. That's gonna be a US win by 450,000 points, bringing the US to a 2-0 lead over Poland.
I don't want to get too excited here,
but I mean, US has got 2 points right now. Poland's really going to have to pull their game together and come back here with a nice rebuttal, or the US might be able to just steamroll this.
I will guess hope in hell now.
Imagine that.
Poland has a chance there with the hope in hell against the United States.
You say that, but I'm looking again at Toy, and they've got Silver waiting in the wings as well.
That's true. Silver performed really well the last time the United States played that map against China. But this seems like going to be a symmetry.
Oh. Now, this is an interesting pick. We've seen Poland do so well on this. They had almost two FCs last time. Rothfuss actually almost FC'd this twice, once missing on the last note, and the second time getting a score that, if with score V1, would have been ranked 4 on the map. So Poland's got a, this is a strong pick for Poland, but can the United States follow up on that as well? They've got some awesome Nomad players as well. I'm looking at Axarius, I'm looking at Natalia, and there's a blank spot in the top right, and it's Silver, of course, who else?
I think we'll be seeing Axarius. I think Natalia, Rizzi, and Axarius will be performing strongly here. I'm not really sure about Silver. Just because his recent performance hasn't been as strong as he's been performing lately, sadly. I think US will be able to perform strongly in this map, like you said, but this is Poland's pick, so obviously they picked it for a reason.
Yeah, I'm looking at Rothfuss and Wobblepuff, especially on Poland's side. Amai Hachimitsu didn't do that bad last time either, but really, Rothfuss with two near full combos in a row on two different matches when this map was picked. So really looking to him for a strong performance.
Yep, but Axarius in these two maps, he got two full combos in a row. He's doing incredibly good. He might be able to put a really strong performance in order to match up at least one full combo from the Polish team.
Yeah, I think so as well, because in the last two matches Poland played, Rafis had a near enough an FC, one FC and another one breaking right at the end. So it's going to be close.
Let's get started. This is the third pick of the match. 2-0 in favor of United States right now.
Yeah. The reason, if anybody's wondering why we're hyping those NRCs so much, this is not the easiest map in the world to full combo. Even if we're not talking about a multiplayer match, there's only about 6 FCs on the leaderboards as of this moment. So this is a pretty difficult map to keep a high combo on.
We do see an early break from Mosh Q though.
Really?
I'm seeing Mr.
Client. Mr. Client decided to mess with me.
Nice birthday surprise for Chippy.
All players performing really strongly this map so far, though.
Oh yeah, nobody's broken combo yet. We've seen some really early combo breaks on this map, but so far all 8 players holding strong. But we're moving towards the first chorus now, which is pretty intense. We definitely see some breaks anywhere else. Here we go.
Really intense because of the non-stop of jumps and streams in combination. And Rafis as well, yeah. Rafis and Wolf, the two ones that we expected more chances of full combo breaking at the beginning of the first chorus. And Natalia is still holding the double S as well, Axarius.
Don't believe Rafis broke.
Oh, no.
But Natalia
Thank you, client.
You can definitely see the anger there with Natalia. Oh no, and then another drop.
Amai too. This is going to be 2 FCs to 2 right now.
Yeah, but that score difference is shrinking rapidly for the United States team. Poland's coming right behind.
You look failed.
The one thing keeping Poland from winning this right now is Wilch's accuracy. If Wilch had like a 99.5 or above, they'd probably be winning this right now, but it's flickering now and it's gonna go towards their end because of the combo.
Yeah, they're closely reaching the lead, but not really with that speed, like Wizard and Axarius are holding incredibly aggressive. Despite Raphis and Pichu holding the full combo, we have to wait and see how WoWoWoof and Amai perform, because Silver and Natalia is having a lot of vicious. That is the difference right here.
Yeah, Poland is performing a lot stronger than their last two picks, but it's not over for the US. I mean, we're only halfway through the map, let's keep in mind. Anything could really happen break-wise. However, yeah. Zilver and Natalia are just not able to hold it together here. Zilver is seeing himself another miss. It's just... Oh, Amai seeing a break, but I don't think that's going to be huge for Poland's end. Ritze, though, seeing a break, that's going to be huge for the US. Yeah. Sorry, it's being the only FC left. This is looking more and more towards Poland's way, indefinitely.
Yeah, the only chance the United States has here is Raphis and Wizju losing the combo. And even with that, WoWoWoof is doing a really impressive job as well.
Breaking. That looks like it's going to be it for US.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we did see a drop there from Wub as well, but unfortunately, Wizju is holding incredibly well. He's got over...
And Raphis.
Yeah, Raphis as well. They're both about to hit over the 1400 mark.
Well, it's breaking, but Raphis is going to be holding the 99 strong.
Amazing performance from the number one of the world right here.
Yeah, he's like played this three times in this tournament, and all three times he's done so well.
Can do it again? He's a really smart pick.
Don't curse him, Doomsday. Don't do it.
It'd be a shame if he were to break here.
That's just
me. Oh. Oh no.
Oh, poor Raphis.
See, that wasn't Marvel.
Oh no.
It could be why.
Oh, and another one from Raphis and Pichu as well. WoWoWoof, but it doesn't really matter. The lead is so big right now. And Poland will take their first point here.
That was a really decent point by Poland.
Really good plays by Raphis and Witch Crew as well. Axarius managed to keep the combo up really good, but it wasn't enough.
Yeah, Poland finally getting into this match. If United States had successfully taken a third point, that would have been a huge blow. But Poland really starting to equalize it here. And the next pick is going to determine a lot of things. Will the US take another two-point lead, or will Poland be able to equalize the points? It is the United States pick.
And it's very true. US has a lead over Poland on their pick. That's going to be huge.
Another hidden pick, maybe?
That means that the US would win before Poland could get to a tiebreaker in the case that they both won their own picks.
Exactly. If they keep swapping points starting now, the United States is in the lead. But of course, a break point, as we've seen, can happen. And this. The actual pick would be Axarius refuting the claim that the Skystar map would be it, so you can tell they're thinking about it. Pupa or Pupa?
Oh, Pupa is going to be.
Pupa. All right.
Well, in a way, this pick is not really that bad. I mean, they have the chance to have an advantage in terms of mods, but you see WoWoWoof. I mean, I'm really scared of WoWoWoof in the free mod bracket.
I'm surprised they're keeping Zilver in for this one. I feel like Toy would be smarter.
Yeah, but especially you have to take into consideration, though, that Toy is on his lag top.
That's true, but he's been performing quite strongly. I think Toy would be able to handle streaming maps pretty fine.
Well, I mean, you have to consider, he did quite well on Evaltech, but Evaltech is not the same as Pupa. This map is just, it's pretty brutal with the jump streams. And while I'm going to have to agree with you that Toy could do really well here, I think having Zilver is still not that great of an idea. I mean, you reckon they would have put Toy in because they're thinking along the same lines, but if he's having technical team, here we go.
Ooh, yeah, okay. Seen a lot of hard rocks in this one. That's a surprise, because this is really tough with hard rock.
Yeah, this is the reason why Zilver would be a good pick for this, is because it is free mod. Like, Zilver is a good hard rock player. He's a really good hard rock player, actually.
Especially with streams.
Yeah, having scores like, and he already has 890,000 points somehow on my screen. Anybody else have that glitch?
Yeah, I just fixed it. Yeah.
That's why they really picked him.
Oh, for Tovnik. That stream, oh boy.
That's really gonna hurt.
It's interesting because this is the second time Fartovnik has actually done this. The last time he played this, he had the exact same problem. He was missed a couple entire streams, and he was not happy with himself after that. You can see his accuracy is suffering a little bit compared to everybody else, but there's also Wubwoof right next to him, of all people, who's suffering on Nomad. Now, that's not something you see every day.
Zilver's accuracy is really good right now, like 99.33 on Hard Rock.
Yeah, indeed. The United States really showing up well here. Natalia and Ritze are suffering slightly, but you look at Zilver, you look at Xerius. I mean, their accuracy is just really unbelievable.
Yeah, Paolo is struggling on this.
Yeah, though Natalia is struggling on... Though Natalia is struggling on accuracy, he also has hard rock. Yeah, so it's basically like a nearing Xerius as S, or well, almost SS on this map right now.
Yeah, and as long as Ritze holds combo, that accuracy isn't too much of a factor. You can see Fartovnik is really struggling here.
The US performing extremely strong right now on this map. They're showing to be a huge wall on this. Really strong performance.
Look at that.
Zilver's accuracy is incredible on this map. That's a ridiculously good run there by Zilver, but can he clear it out, really?
He can, we just have to believe. It's very easy to fail at the end of this map, but you have to watch that life drain. There's a slow part at the end, as long as he gets full SS's on the screens at the end. But if he doesn't, and if we see a fail, so sad, he's dropping accuracy, Zilver, no!
And Natalia's well dropping. Whoa,
they're gonna all do
really
it, they're close.
Watch the HP, Zilver's failing! Watch the HP!
Yeah,
nope, but Zilver's, it's gonna be enough,
I think
it's gonna
got
be
it.
Enough.
I think
he got it, he got it.
It was enough.
Fartovnik, I think Fartovnik died right at the end. Not really sure though, but it doesn't really matter. United States managed to have the four clears and the lead. They took the third point. They are leading 3-1 and it's time to Poland. Let's see if they can react with some picks. I don't really know.
This is just going to be really interesting. The United States, they absolutely destroyed that frame mod. They were holding four full combos for the longest time. As Chippy mentioned, they were just an unstoppable wall. And this is not an easy free mod pick. Even Skystar himself called this map brutal when he was asked about it. It's just not an easy map. You can tell. Look at how Poland, they struggled pretty hard with that one. So whatever they pick. Oh, Deadbeat would have loved it.
I think this is very strong for Poland. I honestly could see a Toy pick here. Not pick. They're not going to pick Toy. Well, they are, but
they're
going to
play Toy as the map.
Yes, I could see US putting in Toy here because this is one of those DT picks where it has that kind of those kind of jumps that are kind of odd shaped, like pattern type jumps.
Yeah, and one thing though is they could even sub in Toy now and it wouldn't be that dangerous of a thing to do. I think that it would pay off more than it would hurt, even if they were to lose this match. They have quite a decent safety net built for them right now.
They really do. I think US is very confident on their picks right now, because especially after that free mod, I mean, we saw such strong performance. Things are looking a lot stronger for the US than it did versus China. They're gonna keep their lineup though.
Yeah, seeing it switch gears into double time, I think this is a pretty clever pick by Poland because we've seen them play this before and they were really, really strong on it. You gotta consider.
Yeah, there's a situation when they really need the point right here because they're in the middle of the match. They have to break as soon as possible. They just cannot break when United hits the fifth point because that's not going to be enough.
This is where Amai really shines. Amai hasn't been playing to their best potential in the last picks, but during the double time picks, Amai has shined so strongly. So I think things will show here.
We have to wait. We're seeing Rock replacing Bichku on here.
Yeah, Rock coming in for this one.
Kind of surprised keeping Silver on double time, though. He played well the last match, though. Or the last, He played well during the last pick, so...
Early accuracy drops, but we're just barely 100 combo in, so that isn't really reflecting what's actually going on. Nonetheless, yeah, you mentioned it's interesting to see Zilver actually pop in for this one, but yeah, he did quite well on Koopa, so who knows? This might be a clever choice. Oh, and I think we see actually the first break from Rock on the Polish side, quickly followed up by Zilver from the US, so score still being even right now. You gotta watch those accuracies. Some players suffering a little, but you see Ritze on 92, Rafis on 94, but they are coming back up now as you get into 300 combo.
Am I gonna be seeing a break along with Rock? That's gonna be 2 FCs to 2 right now. US is leading by a little bit.
Yeah, but if you see any more breaks from anybody, oh boy.
It's not gonna be super fatal though, because the combos aren't that high yet, but Wobblefulp and Ritze are going to be breaking. That's going to be Rafis versus Xarius right now. Rafis has a lower accuracy than Xarius though, so that's going to be a 30k point lead by Xarius.
And this is Xarius. We saw him show up so well during the first match. And of course, it's Rafis with DT. I mean, you can't really expect him to break. If either of them break, though, that's just going to be it for their team. With a third of the map left to go, everyone's watching the accuracies right now. The lead is nothing. 50,000 points. A single break, a single stream, a single jump can change all of that. All eyes. And it's Natalia who breaks, but score still very much in the United States' favor. Amai Hachimitsu also struggling.
Oh, and Rafis now.
Oh, and Rafis is going to be breaking.
Rafis is break. The United States might have their fourth point in the bag.
He's looking very strong for Xarius.
Yes, all up to Xarius to hold the combo right now, but no!
Oh, but no, Xarius can be breaking. Oh my god, these scores are gonna be neck and neck towards the end of the map.
I think the US might be able to take this one.
Yeah, they've got it. I think 100,000
points.
Yeah,
they got it.
Oh! And it looks like, yeah, you guys are right. By 100,000 points, the US are gonna be beating Poland, making it a 4-1, beating Poland 2 times on their own pick.
This is so exciting.
Double time. Like, wow. It's really hard to beat Poland team in double time, and United States somehow managed to do that goal with Xarius with an impressive combo 700. Incredible performance by the United States so far. He was leading 4-1, and they had their pick.
Poland are just in all sorts of trouble right now. They've got to pick it up. They've got to strategize, pull out everything they've got in their arsenal. I'm thinking even hell could actually be popping out soon. Who knows? Oh, the Angel Honey map. Interesting. Xarius.
DJ Fuduji.
Easy 75% accuracy FC.
So we're seeing another free mode here. And I'm not really sure, is this the first time we see an Angel Honey map?
No, we've seen this twice. We saw it yesterday as well.
True, that's true.
I've got to say, I'm kind of surprised the US is taking such a dominating. lead. They've really, really made it happen this match. They played so well. Poland are a little bit off the pace, it seems, really.
This is kind of, honestly, a risky pick for United States. I can see I'm Poland sure, very well winning on this. Actually, with Toyin, I take that back.
Yeah, I mean, this is a pretty good pick for the US, actually.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Poland will definitely do well on it, but I think the US will definitely do well on this as well. They have a good chance.
Yeah.
They've got so many good Nomad players.
Oh, wow.
Well, with 4 points already, they're definitely doing well.
Wolfen and Wilsh are going to be running hard rock. Or hidden.
I don't know, though. I mean, with Toy playing on hidden, it's probably a safe bet for him. This map it's not super duper fast, but it is fast enough for me to worry about laptop leniency there.
Yeah, Vilchku and Wobble Wolf on hidden, I think, is a great choice. Vilch especially is quite known for his excellent hidden skill. Having Natalia on hard rock for this is an excellent choice. I meant to say interesting choice. But it's not a super fast map, but it is a bit aim heavy, so you do have to watch that. Toy on hidden is of course a no-brainer, so I don't know. It's very hard to say who has the advantage going into this one.
Alright, so far we have a lot of double S's going, and just as that, Raph is missing the combo on that. Rock, Axarius, and Risa holding a really strong accuracy, like 100%. As well, Toy, and you didn't notice. Raph is having another break here, and Toy as well having the break. Natalia's not holding the full combo though, so it's two full combos against one. Wolf, Wolf, the only one with hidden holding the full combo so far. Bichq missing in that section.
Yeah, and that's going to allow the US to take a bit of a lead here. Already a bit further ahead, but if you see any break from anybody, I think Natalia might have actually broken there.
Yeah, he did.
So he didn't have to watch it. Oh boy, the lead, right, it's going to decrease again, even though the US is still in control right now, but with the combos being what they are. Oh man, was that a break from Ritze as well?
Yeah, that was a break from Ritze as well. And it's Wubble Wolf against Axarius right now, and Wubble Wolf have the advantage of hidden. So we have to wait and see if Poland can keep this performance up. They might able to pull out that lead.
The scores are closing up, though. It's getting quite close.
Axarius is like the only thing keeping US alive right now, but Wubble Wolf, not really as strong for keeping Poland alive, though he has a really great score. They have great combos on Poland
as
well.
With there being so much time left in the map, they're definitely going to be able to take the lead there. There's so much time in the map.
Their combos are just too strong.
Yeah, the combos are way too high here. The Poland team is definitely... going to take this one, guys.
Yeah, but a miss from anyone can change things.
There is enough time, but
Ritze is gonna be breaking.
I very much doubt we'll see double time, especially after the last one. So, who knows?
There is still one double time remaining? I think United States banned two of them.
Yeah, there was no... If they banned two of them, then they've already played the other DT.
Yeah, there's no more double time for the Poland team. And they also lost it in double time against United States, so they might not want to go for it. Oh,
free mod again.
I told you that they will go for a free mod.
US did so well on Poopa, but this is a very different mapping style. It's not really jump streamy, it's more alternating heavy. And I'm looking at Wubble Fulf right now. He's just going to do so well on this map. I can feel it.
I'm feeling Toy.
Yeah, I'm going to have to agree with you there, Toy as well. Oh, Amai Hachimitsu coming in on the Polish side. Meanwhile, US has a blank space in the top left. Natalia dropping out for, well, who knows? Even though I said this is an alternating heavy map, it's actually not really fast and comparative to these players' skills, so we could see some single taps coming out of Rathis or Xerius, for example. Oh, and it's Silver popping in. Dzyczku dropping out. He doesn't quite like this map, but he is showing his support for Poland. Come on, Poland need this map. They cannot afford to lose this. Shout out to AR9, why not?
Yeah, man, Zilver speaks the truth. So you see it hidden then. No surprise on this one. Hard luck on this is just evil.
Yeah.
Nevertheless. Oh, actually, never mind. Never mind. Poland bringing out the hard rock.
Oh, man, the age-old question. Hard rock or hidden? And, well, we're going to see that being decided in this match. Poland.
I honestly expected Rathis to have hard rock instead of rock.
Well, you say that, but Rathis, being AR9, I think they want him as a Nomad safety, you know? Especially Rathis and Wubblefoof, I think that's a great choice.
Having some really sharp accuracy drops from Rathis and Rock, though.
Yeah, the first third of this map is, like, it's a build-up. It's relatively slow compared to the rest. It's a very long build-up compared to what you see from most maps as well. You do not want to break in this part because it's long, it allows you to build up your combo. And once the song gets more intense, you've really got to watch it. So, this is Rathis' accuracy really suffering unexpectedly. No such breaks from the US, though. They're still holding very strong accuracy. Ritze slightly below 98, but he should be bringing that back up.
I think Hard Rock is honestly a stronger pick on this map.
I thought hidden would be on this, but I guess it depends on the player, whether they're a high AR player or not. Now here we go.
No breaks so far besides that early one from Ritze, so Poland's still very much in control here, but that could very well change. They've got Hard Rock on the fast section, which is conductive to breaks. And I think we might have seen a break from Silver on the US side, so...
Yeah, and then Ritze shortly after.
Oh yeah, you're right. Van going over to Poland right now. Oh, I think Rathis might have actually broken there shortly... Oh no.
Poland has quite the lead right now, but it could sway either way.
Ooh, yeah.
Slightly over a third of the map left to go, and yeah, that break from Amai not going to help. US is slightly bringing the combo back up. Oh, Ritze.
It's going to get really close.
Any break from Toy. Rock, Xerius, or Wolf will just absolutely set the stage here, but I just don't see them breaking any of them. Who knows?
Oh, there is a break.
A break from Rock. A fail from Rock.
And United States is just going to pull it back off of that. Look at the scores closing. Toy, Xerius holding so strong. Could this really be the fifth point? Is this the dream for the United States to take out?
Silver also doing incredibly well.
It's still, if we don't see this for Xerius miss, Poland could be done. US is going to be on match point if they take it.
But now,
was that a break from
Toy? And Toy as well, yeah.
The gap is high. As the map comes to a close, Xerius holding, Wolf holding. United States are just going to take their fifth point here.
It's looking very much like that way. Poland's not able to pull together. Oh my god, US is going to be taking a fifth point on Poland, bringing this to a 5-2.
Poland in dire straits right now.
Worst case scenario for them, they get tiebreaker.
They have such a high hill to climb, though. They need 3 points. And the US picks next.
Yeah, that's going to be great for them. They are at match point. The dream is real, but Poland has been really strong here, and I actually went into this not being very confident in the U.S., and I kind of feel bad talking about it like that. Like, the conversation we had before the matches even got started, guys, that is the real way I felt about it. I felt like Poland was going to steamroll us, and I'm glad for once to be wrong here. I mean, it's been impressive to watch, but Poland's been right on their heels this entire time. These haven't been like crazy wins. It's been close every game.
Yeah, I just have to point out, I mean, we mentioned at the beginning that they wouldn't have Toy, but he's here. Imagine if they didn't have him. His combo mattered so much during that map.
So the US can decide what map to pick, what could potentially be the game. Potentially be another 6-2, but hey.
Yep.
They have 2 selections remaining. I mean, even if they lost this one, they can select again against Poland and hope for a win without a tiebreaker. So they are like relaxed in a way. They don't have to overconfident, but they have a really big chance here.
Just gotta imagine, what could the US be picking?
Oh, right, we have Muteki no Soldier. It's going to be Harrock pick, the first one that we see in this match.
Yeah, it's really interesting to see Muteki no Soldier coming from the US. They did perform quite well on this the last time they played it, which was yesterday, I believe. So Poland is going to have to step it up now. From what we've seen of the US playing this map, I don't expect many combo breaks. Poland, they're just at a point where their backs are against the wall. If they don't win this, it's all over. They need this, and they need this bad.
Amaya says goodbye. Does that mean goodbye for the match, or does that mean goodbye for Pitney? Or playing this map?
I very much doubt they would take out Amaya for this pick, but oh man, who knows?
Even being such a long pick, this song is so cool. It's a really consistent beatmap, though. You have to keep that combo up for a long time if you want to get the full combo. 5 minutes, it's really long. And seems like Axorus and Amai Hachimitsu having the first break so far.
Yeah, this is a very long map, as you mentioned, though, 5 minutes. These early breaks don't really matter at all. You really got to watch, because a series of breaks can really kill any chance you have at getting high points.
Yeah,
well, so far, everything's really even.
Yeah, you have to watch out at the middle of the song. Like, don't drop the combo on that section. It will be really bad for your team if you do so, because of the high amount of combo. Like, you don't have time to recover that if you miss right in the middle.
Ooh, another miss from Xerius is gonna hurt.
That's gonna hurt a lot, especially we're not even a quarter of the way through the map though. Plenty of time for anybody to break and even that out, but going in early, Poland is making up that little distance between them and the US.
Yeah, USA's accuracy is helping them stay almost even, but Poland is definitely pulling ahead now.
Yeah, Silver with a double S. Really impressive.
Yeah, that double S from Silver is actually more than impressive. That's quite amazing, actually. I was just about to say it's a minor thing, but I mean, this is quite an older style map. It was created back in 2012. And you look at who Poland's got, Rock, Wubblewolf, Amai Hachimitsu, they've been around for years. If anything, you'd expect them to be quite strong at this map, and none of them have broken yet. Well, Amai has, but that was an early break. He brought his combo back up now. Oh, that break from Silver is going to hurt, though.
Ritze, too.
Ritze as
those
well.
Those two breaks. United
States. Man. Poland's showing up very strongly in this map, Amai being the only break.
Yeah, just a third of the way into the map.
Oh, but Rock! Rock is missing a miss.
Rock not living up to his name. They was holding up.
But the Natalia and Xarius and the Amai
across the board.
If Wilch and Wolf hold on for just a bit longer, this should be a huge lead for Poland.
It's already a pretty big lead.
Do it.
They're already ahead by 200,000.
Yeah, it's comebackable if they were to miss right now, though.
Indeed, if it's not a break from Wolf or Vince too. US has no FCs remaining though, so if Wolf and Vince could just hold it, then they've got it. Off the backs, Poland is just going to be able to take it.
They don't really need the two of them. With just one full combo should be enough for them to take this point. And again, United States is losing on their own picks. I mean, they might win this one even because of the difference that we have, like 5-2 in their advantage. But they have to take care because they are not picking correctly against the Polish team. And that might be an issue.
Break from Wolf.
Oh, wow.
Oh, why?
Now. And with that break, they've looked at the scoreboards. They know what the situation is now. The pressure on Vilchko will be enormous. He knows his combo. Man. He knows everyone else's combo. He's got to be worried right now. He's got to be worried.
The lead is still 300,000. It's going to be really hard for them to come back, even with a miss from Vilchko.
With a third of the map, Natalia missing. Natalia missing. With the third of the map, though, it's possible if Wilch is to miss, but it looks like he's not going to.
It's really possible. Look at Silver combo. He's doing exactly better than all the other Polish members. Axarius as well, holding up. Rizal with also...
As you mentioned, Axarius! Blame one!
Blame one!
Oh no!
I think at this point, it is probably too late to come back.
Yeah.
Yeah, at this point,
the only way to come back is a fail.
Wilch is coming through really strongly.
Yeah, and Rock and Amai Hachimitsu's also got excellent combos. Ritze and Zilver are trying, but it's not going to be enough. No, I mentioned Ritze and he broke. The curse has spread, I'm sorry. But there you go, Poland. Just looking so strong right now.
Will Bichu get... the full combo? I mean,
he can't. Just a tiny sliver of pie in the top right.
Even without an FC, this is definitely going to be a point for Poland.
Yeah, what a dominating performance on this one. Really bringing it back after being under the cotch for so long.
Oh yeah, on a United States pick too, it's worth mentioning. That's just a huge boost in confidence, and they needed that.
And winning by almost 800,000.
That's decisive.
Very
decisive.
Look
at Vilchko.
And Juan, he almost got away from the curse, but now it's real.
Blame Juan.
Oh, come on.
Blame Juan. Get that hashtag #BlameJuan in their Twitch chat.
That was a very strong victory for Poland there.
Very impressive one. Yes, you are correct.
Now they only have to win on one more U.S. pick for them to get to a tiebreaker. They have to win on their own still, but they only have one more pick from U.S., which is really
With all strong. These maps being played, though, preferred maps from the map pool are running out. They're going to have to go to the maps that they've wanted to ignore now, that they might not have practiced as much, that they might not have wanted to pick as much from the start. So it's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I'm definitely seeing Freedom die after the last pick here. I mean, if Poland can win this one... Cool commentator.
Wolf.
Oh my god, the wolf.
He knows. Juan, wow, that's directed to you.
Oh, Juan, man. He's trying, but it's just, that's the way of things.
And taking a fourth point here and then going on to break point against US, and we see Furioso Melodia, that would just be... quite honestly, possibly the best match of this tournament so far.
And we do have another
call.
Yep, I'm gonna have to interrupt you because we do have another caster subbing in for Doomsday. We're gonna be having Raikou coming in. How's it going, Raikou?
Hello there, I'm so excited to be joining you guys at such a historical moment in the
Oh, that was hype.
It's nice to have you here. It's nice to have you here, especially after that 2-week hiatus due to the internet issue.
Yeah, it was.
Hopefully those are better.
A massive shame, but I'm so excited to be here, and you guys have all done such a great job casting this, getting everyone so excited for such a historical match. Poland and versus the United States. I didn't expect the United States. Historical event to ever happen in an OC World Cup since that famous tiebreaker between South Korea and Taiwan 2 years ago, when Taiwan managed to come back.
I remember that.
I don't know. I mean, a tiebreaker is looking somewhat grim right now, as you see Xariz and Atelier and Zilver with decently high combos, Rafi's being the only FC left. Rock shortly behind, though, so... Poland isn't out of it yet, but it's not looking good for them almost halfway through this map.
Yeah, right now it's all up to Rafi to hold up combo and expect a miss from the United States. Rock also doing a really good combo as well, trying to catch that up. But Silver is just doing incredibly well. Oh, and just as I mentioned, he misses.
#BlameJuan.
Oh my. Oh, Natalia. Missing shortly after. This is looking like This is looking a lot more like a ball game right now.
What is my fault?
Because you said it earlier.
Yeah.
Xariz right being the only FC left on US's side versus Rafi being the only on Poland's.
If Xariz breaks, it's all over for the US. They need him to hold strong.
Well, I mean the same for Poland, but you know.
That's true. It's
US
only
has
Rafi's
quite the
on their end.
We still have roughly a minute of the map left.
Yeah,
oh,
just
look at the
Rock,
scores.
Rock and breaking.
Look at the score. I mean, both teams have the same combos in the same players. Like, Take a look at it.
If we even see one more break from Poland that isn't rock, I think this is over. Maybe breaking wouldn't be bad, but...
And as you mentioned, rock. Oh,
rock,
man.
Failing the map right there. Oh, no. This is looking good for the United States.
Yeah, it was looking a little bit bad with that miss from Zilver, but then Rock just struggled so hard.
If Atreus doesn't miss,
final chorus,
over,
we are going to be
this
seeing
is so
all
close.
That's 100,000 points in it. If Poland don't get it back, it's all over for them. But the
Poland is
hold
really
strong.
They just have to stay with the combos and they will take
they
it.
Need
they
need a break.
Oh, the breaks everywhere!
Oh my god! What
is that?
Is
that it? Rapus breaks! No one in the USA wanted to see that at all! This is crushing!
Oh, Ritze and Rock is the only
decent
combos.
Oh my god!
That's it!
Oh my goodness! What?
That was so close!
And that's gonna be a 6-3! 6-3, United States is going to be taking out Poland. And I'm... Yeah. Amazing performance by United States in the end. Poland was able to almost bring a comeback, but United States performed so much stronger than they did yesterday versus China.
Every single... supporter in the United States right now go absolutely crazy, because that is the most well-deserved win I've ever seen. Unbelievable.
Wow.
Beating the favorites, Poland. That is unbelievable.
That's
in
incredible.
Poland, the team that was slated to win the beginning by just about everybody, they take third place, and the grand finals will be a rematch between the match we had yesterday, the United States versus China. And who would have expected it to end up like this? The Greece beast taking it against Poland. That was amazing.
Unbelievably close, with a score difference of 68,000 points. That was unbelievably close. Congratulations to the winners.
Wow.
That's one of the closest scores we've seen.
Darius has to do a project. Wow.
We also have to congratulate the Polish team because they got the third place. And they played really well. They were really close to force things going longer and longer and maybe even a tiebreaker. But just wasn't enough. Rathface couldn't keep that up, that full combo. And that caused the United States to take that lead. And it was just insane. Everyone.
Poland, they just performed so exemplary.
And this is a historic moment in more ways than one, because neither the United States nor China has ever won an OS World Cup. So for the first time, we're going to see a team that's never taken the World Cup taking it. It's decided. But will it be the US or will it be China? China.
First time that we see them in the finals, actually, and not even winning it. It's the first time that China or United States is on the finals. If I remember correctly, none of those teams have ever achieved at least third place.
Yeah. And for those tuning in, next weekend is going to be the grand finals of United States versus China, who have faced each other in the finals winner's bracket, where United States actually lost against China yesterday.
Very much so. But remember, guys, the United States is going to have to win two matches to take that victory for first. It's going to be an uphill battle for them, while China just has to defend what might be rightfully theirs. But
it's
we won't be able to find out. out till next week.
It's not impossible, Zetrot.
Going by yesterday's turnout, it's looking in favor of China, but with a whole extra week to practice the maps, we have no idea where it's going to go.
Absolutely, and this isn't the first time we've actually seen anyone, any team, climb back from the loser's bracket, because last year, as you famously remember, Poland were denied any shot at victory by Japan, who just came back and took it all away.
Yeah, and the US is just going to have a tough time of it. As strong as they are, as strong as the United States is, they've got China to deal with. China, who've shown up so strong in this tournament. Rust Bell, Matsumoto Rise, Toshino Kyoko. The rosters are just... This is going to be a clash of the titans. It's... I just don't know. Can the Burgers do it?
I don't really know, but they really have a chance.
Yeah, not to mention that Toy will also be included in next weekend with his actual computer and not
without
like
the lag. Oh.
Yeah, he'll be at his very best.
Oh my god, I started feeling the hype and it's just 1 week more. Oh god. We might see an epic comeback from the United States the next week, or we will see China taking all the gold right in the first match. It will be incredible. Like, we see two tiebreakers in a row. That's probably not going to happen, but imagine that situation.
Imagine two tiebreakers would just be an absolute dream for everybody. Both teams, they're just gearing up for the guts, for the glory. It's going to be a hell of a story to see. I can't wait for next week. I'm just so upset we have to wait 7 days. But, well, we do.
Yeah. And guys, remember that you'll be able to watch these matches VOD on Twitch. Make sure to watch this. This is a match to watch. If you're just getting here, you missed one of the greatest matches we could have possibly seen. And remember, guys, with the grand finals on their way, if you really want to show your support, go and get those banners. What team do you want to win? Do you want to see the United States take their first ever OS World Cup? Or would you like to see China take it for the... Would this be... Oh, wait, I got called a hashtag sellout. I feel a little bit bad. but, okay. With all that out of the way, guys, remember, next week is the week to be here, the grand finals of the OS World Cup. And remember, it's only just a week away, and we will see you there.